Today we're diving into one of the fundamental concepts in Dart development, enums. You might be wondering, what exactly are enums and how can I use them to level up my development skills? Well, stick around because we got you. In this video, we'll start with the basics, explaining what enums are and how to use them. And then we'll add some extra functionalities to our enums, making them a little bit more usable. Lastly, we'll touch on Dart's enhanced enums. And we'll do all of this by modifying this app screen, starter code linked in the description below, to ensure all our constant values from the color, the order state, the state description, as well as the icons are all stored as part of a single enum. Let's get to it. I'm pretty sure a lot of you might have noticed that if you wanted to store a list of constant strings, you could just do something like this, create a class and store them like that, but stop. Let's use enums for that. An enum, short for enumeration, is a way to define a set of constant values. It's super handy when you have a fixed set of options or states in your app. Let's look at some basic code. As mentioned before, the link to the starter code can be found in the description down below. What you will find in there is some files, and one of those files is this file right here called enums.dart. In here, you will find there is a custom widget that takes in a couple of parameters. It takes in the color, the title, the subtitle, the icon, whether to show the line, and whether it's active or not. This is to display the status of our order. So, let's get to writing some enum code. To get started, you will have to declare your enum. To do that, you type the word enum, all small letters, followed by the name of your enum. In this instance, it's order status because we are dealing with the status of the order, and it can have multiple values, processing, in transit, and delivered. Let's do that. First value will be processing, in transit, and the last one will be delivered. And there you go. You have your first enum, and we can try to use it. To do this, you type the enum name followed by a dot and the value that you're trying to access, but this does not return a string value. This returns an instance of the order status enum. So since our widget is expecting a string value, we will convert this to string. And we get something that looks like this. This is not pretty. The toString method returns the actual string representation of our enum, but we want the string representation of our enum value. To do that, Dart provides a getter on the values. One of the getters is called .name. We use that and save, and this is what we get. And let's make that uppercase just for good measure. We can try and do the same for the rest of the values. So we do that for in transit. .name and we save, and we see our next problem. We want this string representation to be proper English format, meaning there needs to be a space between the in and the transit. How do we actually achieve that? Let's jump into our next topic. In Dart, you can actually add methods to your enums. So what we're gonna do is add a method, getter, human readable, and we're gonna switch on the this variable, meaning we are switching on the actual order status itself. And we get this error. What this error is saying is that we need to specify all the cases. And we specify our cases for processing, in transit, delivered, and we still now get this error, meaning this cannot be static. Now we save that, and now we have another getter on our enums. Let's use that instead of name. Human readable. And there you go. And we can do that for this one. And there you go. And we can do the same for the delivered as well. There you go. Now, this is great, but suppose we wanted to associate our enum values to more values. For instance, we wanted to associate each enum value to a color or a description or subtitle or an icon. Now, we would pretty much have to do this again and again for the color, for the subtitle, for everything that we have. So I don't think this is going to work. Now let's jump onto the next topic. Dart 2.17 introduced enhanced enum, which makes enum behave more like classes. We can declare our enums with fields, static or instance member, methods, and all of that. So let's declare some fields for this one. We'll declare the fields for title, description, the icon, and I think we'll do one more for the color as well. One more trick that I like doing here is converting my enum to a class so that I can have VS Code to do the heavy work of creating the constructor for me. I will make all of these fields required and change this back to an enum. After doing this, you will see that our enum constructor now needs to be constant. So we'll do that. And our enum values now need to be declared with the given fields. So let's do that for processing. We'll give it the color of colors.amber. We'll also give it the title, the description, and we'll also give it the icon as well. We will then go ahead and do the same for the other values in transit and delivered. We will pass the values as needed and we will end it with a semicolon. You see that we are passing all the values, the color, the title, description, and the icon. And now that we have this, we can go ahead and try to use it. Let's go ahead and do that. So instead of passing it like this, we can simply just call the title for the titles, and we'll pass the description as the subtitle. We'll do the same thing for the icon by saying order status enum.processing.icon. And we will do the same thing for the color. Order status enum.processing.color. And then I will restart just to show you that it's maintaining the state, and I will change the color, save, and you will see that it's actually very responsive. Now that we have that, I think we will do the same thing for the other statuses as well. We'll copy the first one, duplicate it around, change that to in transit. Copy that, change that to delivered, and also change the show line to false. And we are back where we started. But as you can see, we are kind of repeating the same code again and again. There should be an easier way to do this. Now, in a real application, you will have this as a field inside an order class or something like that, which you will get this from a database or something. So let's do that. Let's create a class, call it my order. We will give it the field of the order ID, and we'll also give it a final order status enum and name that our status. So this will hold the status of our order. So we'll create the constructor for that, and we'll also create a instance of this class right in here, and we will create another field inside here. I think we'll implement the copy with method right there, and I think for now that's about it. Let's see how we can use this. In our widget class, we'll create an instance of the order, which I realize now very redundant, and then we'll use this to just replace our order ID, for instance. And we'll also track our order status based on that order as well. Let's just make this look nice. Awesome. Do a hot restart, and that's what we get. I think we'll move our order inside the build method so we can get that on hot reload as well. Let's now deal with the active state of our cards right here. So these cards represent our statuses, right? That means that the order can only be active if our order status is equal to that status, the status of that card. So in this instance, we'll do order status is equal to processing for processing to do the check. And right now, our order status is processing. So we get processing. So let's do a copy with method and change our status to something like in transit, and we get it active. But now the new problem is that the previous statuses are now not active. How do we then deal with this? Firstly, we will comment this out because I don't think this is the most efficient way. What we will do is we will spread over the values of our order status enum. We get that as an array, and then we will map each one of the values to an order status item view, which is our order status card. All of these will be e.color, will be e.title and e.description for that, and the icon will be e.icon. Show line, we'll deal with that in a little bit. For now, let's make that true. And whether or not it's active, to get back to the last point, we'll just copy that and paste that there. And we'll compare that to the current iteration value, which in this case is e. So to deal with show line, I think it's the easier one to deal with. But I think we will need an index, because we will need to just check if this is the last item in our list. To do that, we will have to convert our map to a indexed map, because we need an index value. The map index comes from the collection package in Dart. That's already in there, and it's very handy in situations like this. We will check if our index is less than the order status enum, the values dot length, meaning the length of our array minus one. And as you can see, that is looking pretty good so far, but we're still dealing with the active state. So how do we then solve this one? So in my case, it's a little bit of an easy fix, because the way my states or my values are stored in our enum, they are arranged in a way that the app will actually flow. So I can easily find the index of my order status and compare it to the current index. And if it is greater than or equal to the current index, then we want this to be active. Otherwise, we have not reached that status yet, so it will be inactive. And that seems to be working perfectly fine. And yeah, this is how I would do it. I hope you guys have found this video very insightful. And we've mitigated a lot of code. We've got rid of a lot of code. In fact, we can add another status in here. Let's call that packaging or something. And we will change the color to something like an indigo or something like that. And change the title to packaging, and the description to your order is being packaged. Change the icon to whatever icon you want to change that to, and it's already in the, it's active because our status is delivered and we didn't have to touch any UI code. We just messed with our enum, and the order of our values matters. And there you have it, folks, a quick overview of enums in Flutter development. We covered the basics. We added some additional functionalities. We hinted a little bit about Dart enhanced enums. Remember, enums can simplify your code and make your app development process way easier. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more Flutter development tips and tricks. And let us know in the comment section which method you prefer using, the getters in your enums, or do you like using the enhanced enums definition? Thanks for tuning in to Creative Black, where development meets creativity. Until next time, stay creative.